edition of Mid-South Wrestling Television Network. I'm your host, Boyd Pearson. We have a lot of exciting action and interesting interviews. You'll see Uganda, the giant Kamala, will be here. Also, Mr. Wrestling 2, the popular star from Atlanta, Georgia. Tag team action, Hacksaw Duggan and his partner, Ted DiBiase. And a tag team match, it'll be the Mid-South tag team title holders, the Junkyard Dog and Mr. Olympia, versus the Masked Grapplers 1 and 2. Other great matches on the card, and as our guest commentator to tell you all about it this week, former AAU champion, amateur great from Southern Illinois University, former holder of the Louisiana State Champion, along with the North American Heavyweight title, the very capable Bob Roode.
Well, thank you, Boyd Pierce. You know, I wouldn't interrupt my vacation for almost anything except the fact that 100 million people or so that watch this television program have the right to see not only their current champions, but some of their former champions, and one of their greatest, as a former North American champion. It's my pleasure to be here again.
Thank you, Bob, and we have the first match in the ring. Let's go for the introduction.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner, at 275 pounds from the Big Sky Country of Montana, Rick the Hangman Harris. And in the blue corner, at 236 pounds from Atlanta, Georgia, Mr. Wrestling 2.
Handing his lariat and his hat and vest over to the second, Hangman Rick Harris, against the popular star from Atlanta, Georgia, former North American heavyweight champion, Mr. Wrestling 2, Rick Ferreira. The referee called for the bell. Bob Roop.
Well, you know, these men are uneven in size. Mr. Wrestling 2 is coming off a really impressive win last week, a really hard-fought match with the grappler. And I understand from Grizzly Smith and anybody else that saw it, it was really a tremendous match. This man shows what he's made of. Rick Harris got the size here, definitely not the experience. You can see there, Wrestling 2 has got plenty of agility, speed. He knows his way around a wrestling ring. I've never seen the man phased. Of course, not being able to see his face, it's hard to tell if he's flustered, but his body language has never shown him to be flustered, or he doesn't give the impression that he's ever in trouble, and that's really a psychological advantage for him and a deterrent to his opponents, because it's a lot easier when you see that the man that you're competing against is maybe blown up, out of breath, hurt. So he put some extra leverage on that wrist that time. He might have trapped the thumb. Occasionally with that wrist lock, if you trap the thumb, when you spin under it, if a man doesn't go, he's going to have his thumb broken.
Not only that, Bob, but when Mr. Ashton, too, comes from the dressing room all the way to the ring, the fans everywhere start the familiar chant of 2-2-2. And if I had a word for any of his opponents, it would be WTK, which means watch that knee.
Well, he's patented that move. I've seen a lot of people use a knee lift in different ways, different parts of the body, and knee drops, but I've never seen the knee used as effectively. The man has won literally hundreds of matches with it, and I felt it myself. Of course, I was in good enough shape that it didn't knock me out the way it's done some people, but I definitely still remember it very well. And right here in this match, he's controlling the match. He's a little bit of a mistake here, in my opinion. He's not out the side enough. He's letting Rick Harris pound on him. Maybe he was letting him do that just for that reason. He packs a heck of a wallop. He trapped the thumb again, took him over, and that's a very efficient and effective move in the fact that he's only using a little wrist power on his own, that Rick Harris has taken the brunt of that entire attack. Rick Harris coming off a knee injury, but I talked to him before this match, before the program came on today, and he told me that the rumors that knee is still affecting him are false, that he's completely healed, and he's got the green light, he's back at full steam, and you can see there now, Wrestling 2 did not block himself or guard himself well enough, because he let Rick Harris push him into the ropes and then open up on it with a one to the gut, and now Rick Harris has got him in trouble. He's a big man, deceptively strong. I've seen him pick up men heavier than him. He doesn't have the big bulging type muscles, but he's got maybe that natural strength. Now he is putting the attack to Mr. Wrestling right here. And Wrestling 2 I don't like that thing the fans do with that 2-2-2. I think that's prejudicial, but of course they all have the right to say whatever they want, so I can't do anything about it, except if I was wrestling, maybe they wouldn't be saying that about him. But Rick Harris has got him on the, has really got him on the attack here. He has got Wrestling 2. Now, Wrestling 2 does this a lot. This is another thing, it's an advantage not being able to see his face. You can't tell sometimes. I think he was laying in the woods there. I think he was playing possum a little bit. Maybe just getting his breath, coming back. Ooh, big backdrop. Now that really takes a steam out of somebody like Rick Harris, that 280 pounds. Smack completely into the mat. Ooh, he's gonna do it again, a slam this time. Well, Rick Harris is getting up. Up, that knee, he's perfect position for that knee. Beautiful back to belly flex. Oh, fantastic, and look at that neck bridge. Very good.
1-2-3, a tremendous victory for the men in white, Mr. Wrestling 2. We'll be back after this message from Mid-South Wrestling Television Network. Last week here on Mid-South Wrestling, a sanctioned title match for the Louisiana State Heavyweight Championship. It was a rugged battle between the champion and the challenger, Iron Mike Sharp versus the challenge of Hacksaw Duggan. Duggan gained the victory, became the new Louisiana heavyweight champion. Let's join the closing moments of that title match.
Hacksaw just keeps coming. This is the thing about him. He's almost unstoppable. I mean, you finally wonder what it takes to slow him down, to make him take a breath, to get him off his course. He just is relentless. But Iron Mike is known to be relentless too. A tremendous right hook into the stomach. That'll slow you down. Reverse chop. And he's delivering a forearm smash right into the back of the neck. That'll snap you like a whiplash. Mike again went for a high risk move, but you have to do this. And Hacksaw pulled up. Look at the power of Hacksaw to lift Iron Mike Sharp up and just hold him. He just holds people, and then he runs around the ring and batters them into the ring post. You can't imagine how much power that takes to be able to do that. Backbreaker. And Hacksaw going for the coup de grace, but Mike moves. Iron Mike going for broke. He's proud of that title that he won from Killer Khan right here on Mid-South Wrestling. Over a pile driver, but Hacksaw drove him back into the turnbuckle. Mike's still firing out of it. These men are pulling out all stops. They're going 150%. He's pulling him back in for the pile driver. That's Mike's favorite hold. But the Hacksaw's getting his, well, Mike's got him up. They went too far. Mike went for the reverse backbreaker, and the Hacksaw went clear over his head into the corner with the referees calling for the break. Hacksaw out of the way, and Mike's run into that immovable object, those turnbuckles. Those are steel cables. They don't have a lot of give. Hacksaw reverse forearm. Spear! There he went with the spear, that high-risk move. He doesn't care if he hurts himself, and it looks like he's stunned Mike. We have a new Louisiana champion. Boyd Pierce, we have a new Louisiana champion right here on Mid-South Wrestling, Hacksaw Duggan.
Boyd, I want to let all these people out here know the way that Hacksaw Duggan was feeling, because my first match at Mid-South Wrestling, I know you remember, my very first match here, I won that Louisiana heavyweight title, and I'm telling you, when you know that 100 million people or so are seeing you being a champion, a true champion, it's really a great feeling, and I congratulate Hacksaw Duggan on that win.
We have the tag team match in the ring now, so let's go for the introduction and a rugged action.
And now it's tag team action for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 265 pounds from Omaha, Nebraska, the North American heavyweight champion, Ted DiBiase. And his partner at 270 pounds from New York City, the brand new Louisiana heavyweight champion, Hacksaw Duggan. In the blue corner at 221 pounds from Anderson, South Carolina, Ted Allen. And his partner at 250 pounds from Atlanta, Georgia, Marty Lundy.
Tag team action. Ted Allen in the black tights, and in the aqua trunks is Marty Lundy. And across the ring, their opponents, Ted DiBiase, the North American heavyweight champion, and the Louisiana state title holder. You saw who won it right here last week, Hacksaw Duggan from New York State. Remember, next week, the big showdown, Bob Roop, for the Mid-South Tag Team Championship. It'll be the Junkyard Dog and Mr. Olympia defending against these same two men, Ted DiBiase and Hacksaw Duggan. And, of course, the stipulation, the loser of the fall must leave Mid-South for 60 days.
Well, boy, I couldn't help but notice how proud that Ted DiBiase, you know how much he covets that North American title. Jim Duggan proud of that new Louisiana title, and yet they're both putting them on the line next week. I'll tell you in just a minute, this action in the ring is something. Ted Allen moved out on the offensive right there real quick, but DiBiase's got about 50 pounds of weight on him anyway. And of course, he's not the North American champion by a slouch. I wrestled against him for a long time, and the man is capable. Hacksaw Duggan, a lot rougher around the edges, but in his own way, just as effective. Again, oh, look at that power. He horsed the man up just easy as pie. Ooh, a shoulder breaker. Now, that's not a finishing shoulder breaker, but it is a move that will really take it out of a man. And Duggan definitely punishing his man now. Body language shows he's a little bit unconcerned right here. I know, again, they're thinking of that big showdown next week. I had to ask Grizzly Smith how he managed to get a match like this signed, and all he would do is give me a big smile and kind of pat himself on the back, because everything's at stake, because the loser of the fall between Ted DiBiase, Hacksaw Duggan, and Junkyard Dog, and Mr. Olympia, first of all, the belts are at stake. Ooh, great action here. Again, the belts are at stake. Then no disqualification, the belts are going to change hands, plus the loser of the fall has to leave the area for 60 days. Well, if a champion can't defend his belt within 30 days, he has to forfeit it. So if DiBiase lost, he'd also not only leave for 60 days, he'd have to forfeit his North American title. Same for Duggan, same for Olympia with a Mississippi title. And of course the Dog has got a lot of prestige plus those tag team titles. And if he has to leave, let's face it, the man's a superstar. The amount of face he would lose would be tremendous. Everybody in the country would be after him, trying to get a piece of him while he's still around. So again, a lot at match. I can understand. Grizzly Smith just says he's calling it a showdown, and I don't blame him, because there's a lot at stake, and somebody's going to have to show a lot of courage, for one thing, going into that kind of match, because somebody's going to lose something. Again, back to this match in action. I'm excited about that match next week myself. I'm just glad I'm not in it. But here, Marty Lundy. Very impressive build. Young man. Obviously in good shape. He and Ted Allen make an effective team. It's obvious that they've tagged together for some time. They complement each other, but again, we're talking about North American champion, Louisiana champion, top contenders for the tag titles, Mid-South tag titles. They're wrestling against a very effective team, DiBiase and Hacksaw Duggan. Now, Ted Allen showing some fire. Well, DiBiase took a few punches. When the drop kick came, he simply stepped back out of the way. He's a young man, but a very wily veteran in a lot of ways. Of course, coming up in a wrestling family helps. He was watching wrestling matches when he was 3 years old. Ooh, clothesline. That hurts. DiBiase made me about 2 inches taller last year with that move. Oh, the spear! Fantastic move. That Duggan, this is a powerhouse team. Powerhouse. Next week is going to be something, Boyd.
Hacksaw Duggan and Ted DiBiase priming up for the showdown battle next week for the Mid-South title. We'll be back. Kamala the Ugandan Giant in action after this word from Mid-South.
This event is for one fall or remaining television time. In the blue corner at 240 pounds from Charlotte, North Carolina, Bob Stabler. at 6'8", 385 pounds, the Ugandan giant Kamala.
Bob Stabler and the Blue Tights taking on the big Ugandan giant Kamala. Now, Bob, Ruth, you was here a couple of weeks ago when for the first time we viewed Kamala as he burst upon the scene and literally birthed the man awesome and hugeness that he is, with the power that goes with it. And the unorthodox tactics really adds up to something. And we've been viewing the past few weeks, he is really something that we've never seen before in the Mid-South area.
Well, Boyd, you got a good point there. One thing that I've noticed is that there's a lot of talk about the punishment he deals out. But one thing I've noticed is that nobody in that match that I commentated on, his opponent wasn't able to faze him at all. You know, while we got a moment, I heard from the guys in the dressing room, the guys that will talk to me, that there's a lot of big things happening in Houston, big matches, big crowds since Mid-South. The Mid-South wrestling program has gone in there. Apparently attendance is about doubled or tripled. You know, that's really great, because I've always felt that Mid-South has the best wrestlers. I know when I was here, they sure did. Again, back to Kamala, this man on the offensive. Again, nobody has seen what he can take yet. I saw Jesse Barr last week on television. I saw Jesse Barr come over the top rope with a drop kick. It didn't even faze the man. He has just eaten up his opponent so far. And people are talking about him taking on some tougher opponents. I hear the name of Mike Sharp, for example, a Junkyard Dog. And Andre the Giant, some big people. He's a giant himself. But again, another thing, how long can he wrestle? He's eating up his opponents, just beating them up in 3 or 4 minutes. And is the man in good condition? Can he carry that weight? But he's done a tremendous slight job so far. And he's got this unorthodox, ooh, that splash across the man that crushes the thorax. Crushes the thorax against a hard surface like that, Matt. This is punishment now. He's punishing him. That's good. He's punishing that man. Very impressive, boy.
A victory for the big giant from Uganda, Giant Kamala. We'll be back. The Junkyard Dog and Mr. Olympia in a Mid-South tag team match after this word from Mid-South Wrestling.
Now a non-title tag team event for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner, at a total combined weight of 484 pounds, the Grapplers, 1 and 2. Mr. Olympia.
Tag team action now. The Grapplers, 1 and 2, against the Junkyard Dog and Mr. Olympia, who are the title holders of Mid-South Tag Team Wrestling. Alfred Neely called for the bell. They're ready for action, Bob. We saw earlier Ted DiBiase and Hacksaw Duggan gain a victory, and now the champions are in. Remember, next week it'll be the showdown for the title here on television. No disqualification. One fall. Loser of that fall must leave Mid-South for 60 days, so it all coming down to a head.
Well, it is, Boyd. It's to a point, you know, and there's some psychological maneuvering going on here. Hacksaw Duggan and Ted DiBiase earlier had a very, very impressive win, but not over men of the caliber that the Grappler and the Grappler 2 have established themselves to be. This is a top team that the Junkyard Dog and Olympia, and you can see there now, Junkyard Dog just held that man down while his partner came in. They're showing Hacksaw Duggan and Ted DiBiase, I guess, that they can get with it too. And if it's turn time to get nasty as far as using teamwork, now that's some beautiful maneuvering by Mr. Olympia by himself, using his upper body strength and his legs, a lot of agility, but also a mistake on the part of grappler two. Get too close to that corner in that position, should have turned the man around the other way. But again, now, of course, Junkyard Dog and Olympia are taking a lot on themselves. If they get beat in this match, they're going into, even though it's a non-title match, they don't lose anything except some prestige, but they go into next week as losers. So, I mean, ooh, Junkyard Dog, ooh, headbutt in the back of the head. The grappler in there now, you can tell the difference. He's got those that elevated shoe where his foot was hurt. Tough, tough man. Grappler 2, trained by him in the same class. Not as tough, though. He's scouting. You saw him get out of the ring. Maybe he's smart. I don't know. Grappler's back up on his feet. He's ready. This man takes a lot of punishment. He's not afraid to get in there with anybody. Been a North American champion, Mississippi champion, Louisiana champion, a great competitor. And you saw him right there. Now, this is what I was talking about. Hacksaw Duggan and Ted DiBiase, if they're watching this, they got to be really liking this, because they just saw Olympia expose a weakness there. He can be countered going into the turnbuckle. That shoulder was thrust in there pretty hard. It's hard enough to immobilize him here. Now these men are smart. Grappler tags right out, tags grappler two in. Keep him in the corner, keeping him in the corner. I shouldn't tell them what I do. They're keeping him in the corner. If they're smart, they'll tag in and out on him, bringing all their strength to bear. Fresh man in every 30 seconds or so, taking the five count. You got 5 seconds, a five count, where both of you can work on the man. And hey, Junkyard Dog and Olympia did it a couple seconds ago. Why not do it themselves? It's smart wrestling. The object is to win. It's not a nice guy's sport.
Bob Roop, all the top stars are here today and this week in the area. And can it be far behind? We're talking about the extravaganza to Superdome. It cannot, because it'll be Thanksgiving night at 7:30 in New Orleans. All the top stars are coming from everywhere. Our promoter now and matchmaker Grizzly Smith trying to sign not only the wrestling star, but cinema idol from Mexico, the high-flying Mil Máscaras. Also Chavo Guerrero, gorgeous Gino Hernandez, Mr. USA Tony Atlas, and all pointing up to a fall season there at the Superdome and all the other big shows coming up in November.
You know, boy, that's great. They got a little bit cautious there. That's great. You're talking about these competitors. I love competition. That's ridiculous. They're bringing in some of the best people in the world. Grizzly Smith has lost his mind. I mean, he's doing his job too well. Junkyard Dog back in the ring there. Olympia, they let him get too close and make the tag. Dog in there. Now they're using teamwork, both in the ring at the same time. Now there's a double counter. Ooh. Grappler stopped Olympia. Junkyard Dog headbutted, and now it's thumping. Grappler two. Grappler can't make the save. Very impressive victory.
The Junkyard Dog and Mr. Olympia, the Mid-South Tag Team title holders, gain a victory. We'll have more action coming up after this message from Mid-South Wrestling.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner, at 300 pounds from Moscow, Russia, General Skandor Akbar proudly presents Vladik Smirnov. And in the blue corner, at 218 pounds from Knoxville, Tennessee, Tim Horner.
Upper Tim Horner in the green being introduced. After his opponent across the ring was announced, General Skandor Akbar with his latest addition to his stable, 320-pound Russian Vladik Smirnov. All the top stars, as we said earlier, Bob Roop, are on the way because of the Superdome in New Orleans and all the big shows around the area. And Superdome, of course, on Thanksgiving night, Mil Máscaras, Wahoo McDaniel, Chavo Guerrero. They're all being contacted, trying to be signed for that super spectacular card. As you see now, Tim Horner and Smirnov. Take it over, Bob.
Well, thank you, Boyd. You know, again, what you were just talking about. Ooh. Now that, Smirnov. turnoff is strong. He showed a lot of using that weight well. Applied some laws of physics there, the way he whipped Tim Horner around, working on the back area. Grizzly Smith signed up all these top guys. In my mind, he could have saved me a lot of money if he'd have told me he was doing that. I've been going around scouting people, and then I find out that here, they're all coming here, including
all
one of
the top
them.
Stars coming here. That brings up a question. You say you're on vacation. When are you going to start back wrestling?
Well, Lloyd, I was just telling you what I've been doing. I've been going around scouting people, but I'm also applying some specialized training. But I don't want to tell you what I'm going to be doing in the future, if you don't mind, because it's going to cost some messes. Nice move by Tim Horner there, moving out of the way, countering with a reverse cradle. But he got up. He's a little bit out of it. He got up with his back to him, man. Never do that. Again, Boyd, no hard feelings, but I'm going to leave the future. I'm going to let some people find out the hard way, if you don't mind. Junkyard Dog's got a few things coming to him. He stole the North American title from him, even though Ted DiBiase took him off him in 1 week. But there's some people who got a few things to hear from Bob Roop that they'll be hearing in the future. Again, this Smirnoff, Vladek Smirnoff, a lot of size. Tim Horner is unless he's hurt in his career, he is going to be great. He's keeping some fast company. I've read about him being teamed with Buck Robley. And he's a comer. Whether he's there yet, this match could go a long way towards determining. He's got a man that's probably half again his size, obviously more experienced, uses a European style, a style that's unfamiliar to him. Tim Horner tried some of his earlier offensive weapons, the drop kicks, had no effect on the man. What he needs to do, he's using a little bit now, but not effectively. The man's bear hug is tight enough. Apparently all he did was irritate him a little bit, back into it. Now, Tim Horner needs to get nasty here, because if he bit his nose off, for example, I don't think that the man could sit there and keep that hold. But anyway, maybe Tim Horner didn't hear me when I was saying this is not a sport for nice guys. Anyway, he's in that bear hug, and Smirnoff is putting the pressure. And you notice that angle there now. He's leaning into him. He's making him carry his weight, too. So he's putting that pressure up under the short ribs in the back, and he's leaning his weight into him, making Tim Horner carry his own weight plus Smirnoff's. Now, Horner used a little smarts there. Slap those ears one at a time or both at the same time. The bells start ringing. Very disconcerting, distracting. Now, Smirnoff is giving the appearance of either being very confident or disorientated. I guess it's confidence. Oh. Strength. The man's very, very strong. Big, powerful legs. Strong upper body, using the bear hug, obviously. But big backdrop. Tim Horner was at least 8 feet in the air. Nice, little bit, missed one move and countered with another. Good reflexes. And he gets a three count.
From the stable of General Skandar Akbar, the Russian Vladek Smirnoff gains a victory. We'll have more action coming up after this important message.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 238 pounds from New York City, Vinnie Romeo. And in the blue corner at 287 pounds from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, Iron Mike Sharp.
A battle between two very capable contestants, Iron Mike Sharp, former Louisiana heavyweight champion, against Vinnie Romeo. Bob Roop, next week, we told him about the showdown that's going to be here, and our special guest viewing it next week is going to be right here on television as special guest to Cowboy Bill Watts. There'll be 50 fine children plus the staff from Summit Oak Center in Lanesville, Texas. They're enthusiastic. They like the kind of wrestling that we have here on Mid-South, and they'll be Bill Watts' special guest, all 50 children plus the staff, here next week. So we look forward to seeing them, real fans, and they'll be here with us.
Well, I'm glad the kids could be here. It's nice of Bill Watts to do that. I don't think I'd do it, but then I'm not Bill Watts, and kids have their place. But anyway, you know, if I was Mike Sharp, Vinny Romeo is a really good competitor, but he is not rated in the top 10 in the country or the world, or does not have an international reputation yet. And it's not saying he won't. He's obviously trained himself down. He's in fine, great shape. Very little, I don't see any fat on his body. His stomach muscles rippling. Very impressive physique. Experience he's lacking. Now, Mike Sharp is former champion. This next few matches, especially on television, after you lose a major title, and I understand last week he lost the Louisiana title to Hacksaw Duggan. No controversy, no interference, nobody ran in. He just got beat. And in that sense, the next match is very important to him. I would ask for a match with Andre the Giant or Godzilla or somebody really, really bad to try to beat them, to show people that just because I lost a title doesn't mean that I'm, you know, that I'm washed up or that I've psychologically lost my edge, because everybody has an off day. You know, sometimes a baseball team will win 2-1 one day and the next day they'll get beat 13-0 or something like that by the same team. So, I mean, every team has their, every person, every athlete in competitive sports can have an off day. Their biorhythms can be wrong. It can be all kind of things, problems at home, whatever. But Mike Sharp, now again, I'm not saying he's ducking the issue. Maybe he couldn't get the kind of opponent he wanted. And I'm not saying that, again, Vinny Romeo, a win over him would be good on anybody's record book. But again, Mike Sharp being the, ooh, now again, he's showing, that was impressive. Yes, one, he finished it with one move. He doesn't look like he's lost anything.
Now for Neely raising the hand of the victorious Iron Mike Sharp. Action continues after this word from Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.
This event is for one fall or remaining television time. In the red corner at 270 pounds, from Vancouver, British Columbia, Kelly Koniski. And in the blue corner at 236 pounds from Portland, Oregon, Jesse Barr.
From Portland, Oregon, in the red, white, and blue, Jesse Barr. And from across the border of Canada, Vancouver, British Columbia, Kelly Koniski, the son of former world heavyweight title holder Gene Koniski.
This should be good, Boyd. Couple of great athletes here. Young. I don't know how mean they are. Every man's got the capability to be real mean. He just needs somebody to bring it out. But again, oh, good counter by Koniski. Good counter. Jesse Barr went for an arm drag. Koniski pulled the arm out. Go behind. Takedown. Waist lock takedown. Falling around. Inside switch. Sit out. Any of you amateur wrestlers out there? Oh, another switch by Jesse Barr this time. Sit out again. Loose ride, Jesse Barr too loose.
Bob Roop, next week we told him the showdown for the Mid-South Tag Team title. It'll be no disqualification, one fall. The loser of the fall must leave Mid-South for 60 days. It'll be the Junkyard Dog and Mr. Olympia against Ted DiBiase and Hacksaw Duggan. But another thing we want to point out, this is a showdown battle. It'll be the first match on next week's television show. All other bouts will be standby, so there'll be plenty of time in case any of the fans are wondering.
You mean there's a whole hour for that
match?
That's
possibility right there.
Well, that's great. That way there's got to be a winner, right?
That's exactly right. Must leave Mid-South for 60 days, and there's no disqualifications.
Well, Charlie Lay and Grizzly Smith really put together something this time. I might have to interrupt my vacation again just to watch that, boy.
We're also trying to get Mr. USA Tony Atlas and gorgeous Gino Hernandez for next week, and for Japan, the international stars Hiro Matsuda and Yoshi Yatsu. So it all adds up to every week gets greater and greater as we move into the holiday season and all the big wrestling cards, Superdome in New Orleans and all the area cards. So all the top stars to the Mid-South area.
Hiro Matsuda is a legend in Japan and the parts of the United States. He's coming in here too. Grizzly Smith is doing his job much too well. I mean, it's going to be really hard to be a champion in this area. There's going to be, everybody's going after Mid-South titles. Back to this match again. These two young men have as you fans have been watching while we've been talking about a couple other things. A lot of agility, moves, psychology, counters to counters. Just some good old-fashioned scuffling. Both these men have fine amateur backgrounds. Now, Kaniski, again, the son of a former world champion, which I think was a little bit unfair. I mean, my father's a college professor, PhD in engineering. I think that I'm handicapped because my father wouldn't be in a wrestler. Maybe it'd be fair to keep these guys out, and I'm just kidding about that. Of course,
Sandy Barr coming up from an athletic family in the wrestling world. His father, Jesse Barr. His father is Sandy Barr, and he's Pacific Coast champion for many, many years. So,
well, see, these guys have a big advantage over someone like me. It's just, I'm glad I'm just very talented because the fact that, again, they grow up in the sport. I grew up going to school and doing things like that. A lot of beautiful move. Referee Rick Ferreira, resident of Pineville. Understand he's got a new business raising chihuahuas. Again, the match. Again, Sandy Barr. Yeah, I've heard of him. Great competitor. The match has slowed down a little bit, but I don't see how anybody keep this pace. When I wrestled in the Olympics, the matches were 9 minutes. About 7.5 minutes, things started slowing down a lot, even against the Russian 400-pounder. I finally had to suplex him and beat him because I was blowing up. Now they're getting a little rougher. I was talking about being mean earlier. Sometimes sit-outs and switches and sit-outs, duck-unders and turn-ins just do not do enough. You have to put an elbow in somebody's gizzard. Well, he went to the well too often there, and Jesse Barr kicked him right in the face. That was a good counter. Now right here, Jesse Barr ought to jump on him and jump up and down on him about 4 or 5 times. But anyway, that's his philosophy, and he'll win and lose by it, and it's his business. I got a lot of respect for the guy. He's obviously trains hard. He's got a great physique, great body, great strength. He was a junior Olympic champion. I can identify with that. Kelly Kaniski again, wrestling family, great athletic background, letterman in 4 different sports. Take nothing away from these guys. I'd love to have him as my protege. The first thing I'd do is talk to him about being vicious. Because, I mean, like in other sports, in football, when they put the quarterback out for the season, that's considered the lineman that does it is given an extra gold star to put on his helmet. Look at Hacksaw Duggan. Every talk about it, he got kicked out of football for being too nasty, and that's to his credit in wrestling rather than to his detriment. So, I mean, again, it's great. I want these guys to do well. I want them to have a big reputation and everything, so I can go against them and beat them, and I really beat somebody. And I'm not just talking about these guys, anybody. Ooh! Now, he went for a belly-to-belly suplex there. It looked like he dropped Jesse Barr right on his head. He did. 1, 2, 3. He dropped him right on his head.
Hard-fought battle, and coming out on top, hand raised in victory, Kelly Kaniski over Jesse Barr. Bob Roop, pardon me just a minute, as Ted DiBiase and Hacksaw Duggan.
We got a little bit to say. I just hope all you people out there watching enjoyed seeing the Junkyard Dog and Mr. Olympia today, because it's probably going to be one of the last times you get to see one of them. Because next week, right here on this TV station, Mid-South cannot interfere. One person is going to lose a fall, and whoever that person is going to have to leave Mid-South for 60 days. There's no disqualification. There's no rules. There's no way that Mid-South can steal the titles from us again. You got the North American champion. You got the Louisiana State champion, and you're going to soon have the Mid-South Tag Team Champions.
It's about time Mid-South did something that was okay with Ted DiBiase and myself. They've been protecting people. Now we got the kind of match we want. It's no DQ, and that's the kind of match that we thrive on. That's the kind of match that we love. And the loser is going to have to leave town for 60 days.
You know, we're making a lot more money now that we have all the titles, so we can go ahead and we'll buy a set of luggage for whoever it happens to be. Junkyard Dog can get a 60-day vacation to go see his family, or Mr. Olympia can go to wherever he's from, but one of them, I guarantee you, one of them is going to lose next week, and you're going to have new Mid-South Tag Team Champions, and you're going to be minus one Junkyard Dog, or Mr. Olympia.
That's the showdown battle next week right here on television. Mid-South Tag Team title on the line, Junkyard Dog and Mr. Olympia against Hacksaw Duggan and Ted DiBiase. The loser of the fall must leave Mid-South area for 60 days, no disqualification. Until then, Boyd Pierce saying goodbye, everybody. Thanks so much for watching on Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.